There's voices. I'm sat outside the machine where people pay for their... Yes, look, look. It may work, it may not. We shall see. I've just done a kind of a catch-up vlog. I wanted to start Vlogmas today. I'm having a little break for until Christmas on my main channel. I was going to do the same on this, and then I thought, Vlogmas. So, I'm doing Vlogmas, which is only going to be once per week. It's not going to be like every day. So, when I was starting Vlogmas, I started a little catch-up talk, and then I thought, no, this is me telling more stuff about stuff that's happened with a neighbour over the past couple of weeks. But then I thought, I can't have this in Vlogmas, complaining about my psychopathic neighbour. So I'll probably put that in a little catch-up. And this is me doing Vlogmas. So 1st of December today, I am about to go into the hairdresser to get my roots done. Look at that. So you can see how bad that is, how grey that is. Oh dear me, look at that. What she said was, I've got most of my grey is underneath here, the temples. There's not very much at the back at all, which makes it difficult, more difficult to lift my hair up lighter. Today's not a lightning visit, it's a, I don't have a watch on. Today is a roots visit, so I'm about to go, you see my little robins, I'm about to go and get that done now. So I shall go forthwith and I shall return to you when it's done. I may film a little bit of the tower centre because I need to go and get some slippers. So if the first thing you see after this may be me going to get some slippers. I shall catch up with you guys in a couple of hours.
Oh, my love, we've had a share of tears. Oh,
off yet, so I am not putting the microphone on. My hair looks pretty similar, it's just tidy and I've got no grey roots. They didn't lighten it obviously. This is the colour it's been now for a couple of months. I am back at the end of January for another lightening. So yeah, that's that done. My hairdresser's really nice, she's chatting away. So I don't dread going to the hairdressers, and I used to. For me, going to the hairdressers was like going to the dentist. But now that my hair's like tidy and not really shit condition, I don't feel as bad because I don't feel I'm going to get lectured like I used to, which I used to get a lot about split ends and there's no point in having your hair long like this if it's not going to be in good condition. And I used to think it was really rude. And yeah, I can see their point, but you know, it's not up to you to tell a customer that their hair looks like shit, which is what hairdressers always used to do to me. So I've got myself a pair of slippers. They're just like little pink booties because my elf slippers are got dog treats for one of my friend's dogs, because I said we're not doing like presents this year other than like direct family, so we're not like doing friends and stuff. So what am I doing? So like if someone's got a child, obviously I'll get the child something, or like a dog or a cat or something. But we weren't doing where's my dress? We weren't doing like, I just couldn't afford, I'll be honest, I can't afford to. I literally don't have the money. I've spent all my money from the last two Christmases now having my hair done. I spent the last of it today. So thankfully the next time I have an appointment after my birthday and Christmas, and I'm hoping, is that woman, oh jeez, I thought she was going to walk right in front of the car. My mum's given me money because she can't really get to the shops for me because I'm the one that takes her to the shops. I wonder if there's much difference in audio. It'll be interesting to compare. So then I'll use that money to get my hair done the next couple of times. So it's ridiculous. I've spent all the money that I got for my birthday and Christmas for 2 years basically trying to get my hair sorted out. But it's like 20 odd years of just dyeing my hair black and doing nothing to it, having the odd cut. Like I had my hair cut a few times, had a fringe put in and stuff, but my face is too fat for a fringe. Next year, I keep saying this, and you're going to be thinking, oh Lisa Bullocks, you're always saying this, next year I am properly, I will lose weight, because when we went to Florida last time I lost 2 stone before we went, because I was mortified at the thought of getting stuck or not fitting on rides. And then when I got there I realised, no, I'm not that big. I need to lose at least 2 stone before we go to Florida in August. So January, I'm going to start being really, really careful.
Oh God.
So, what was I bringing? Yeah, so if I can lose a bit of weight and I don't feel like a heffalump, I might get a fringe cut back in. And the only reason I'm thinking about getting a fringe is these lines on my forehead. They're expression lines, I realise. So I don't know, we'll see. I think it's because I had a fringe the whole time I was growing up as a child, and it wasn't until I was able to pick my own hairstyle as a teenager that I didn't have one, which is why I still don't have one. I had one for a while, but when I looked back at pictures of it, I hated it. The only time I liked it is when the hairdresser actually cut it, you know, on the day. So it's a bit frustrating having to wait so long to get my hair lightened, but it's the only sensible way to do it. Previous old me would have taken to my hair with bleach myself and attempted to do it in one sitting. Oh, somebody's been written up by a traffic warden. Someone's getting a ticket. You'll be able to see them after I drive past them on this side on the bonnet of the car. She's getting her driving license out to show them for some reason. Can you maybe see there? So what was I saying? It's the only way to do it, to keep my hair in decent condition. I took a little bit of footage in the Tower Centre of the decorations, purely for Alan, for Kermit's ghost, who lives in Brighton, and he was having a right rave about how bad their Christmas decorations were. So I thought I'd film. That's one of our shopping centres, it's quite nice. I couldn't film the middle properly. The middle's got Santa's grotto, and it's got loads of little animals, you know, like that move and stuff, but there were loads of kids around and Santa was there, and I didn't really want to be walking around with the, you know, filming. I looked a bit odd, so I'll maybe try and get a little bit more on Friday night when I'm in, but it looks quite nice. The town hall looks gorgeous. It always has masses of lights on to look like a Christmas present. Right, I'm not going to talk anymore because I don't have my mic on and I don't want these vlogs to be full of me waffling. So I shall catch up with you guys. I can't think of anything of any interest to tell you today. Nothing really is happening. I'll catch up with you guys tomorrow night. We're going into the pantomime, so we'll catch up with you then, no doubt. And I shall check in with you guys later. There we go. Darren's walking them down. It's Isaac, Robert with the light coloured trousers, and Kayla. They're going down to where that big tree is. There they go. He's walking them down because you can't trust them near roads, which is ridiculous. Of course, this is going to pick a time for loads of traffic. I'm filming. There's a little dog coming up. Wee, hello. Yes, I know this isn't very exciting for you folks, but yeah. It's little memories for me of them going to pantomime with scouts. Off they go.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well. It's the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, and the thing that'll make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. Sure, it's Christmas once more.
Right, Alan, I'm doing some street filming for you like a prats did here. There's lights there. There's lights up there. Granted, they're not the most exciting, but they're there. And there's lights down here. There you go. Hello, it is Saturday. Molly's here, Dobby's here, Isaac is doing God only knows what down there. We are about to get the stuff for our Christmas decorations done today. So you shall probably see me in a few hours' time looking a lot more red-faced and disgruntled. Darren is bringing in the decorations from the garage. So we shall check in with you when it's all done.
Churchill comes over here to say we're doing splendidly. But it's very cold out here in the snow, marching to and from the enemy. Oh, I say it's tough, I have had enough, can you stop the cavalry?
My car's just switched off. I am just about to go see Violent Night, which I'm very much looking forward to. Or cinema never keeps movies like this for very long. I'm surprised we're even getting it. I cannot wait to see this. This is just my cup of tea. So let's go check out Violent Night. Here for Violent Night, and I'm on my lonesome. The cinema probably can't see, it's empty at the minute. Fingers crossed. Hello, it is Sunday, last day of Vlogmas week one. We're just heading into my mum's. I'm just pressing all the buttons in the car I need to press. Isaac has a week of exams next week, and it is terribly timed because he was just given, when he went to jiu-jitsu on Saturday, he's got his grading for jiu-jitsu on Thursday night. He doesn't normally do jiu-jitsu on Thursday nights, but that's when they do the gradings. So it's also my birthday, so I knew that this week when it was my birthday we'd be doing revision for Isaac's exams, because he's got, like, some days he's got three exams. But now, the day before he's got three final exams on the Friday, he's gonna be doing his jiu-jitsu all evening. The grading takes quite a while, there's getting there and getting home. Yes, I was gonna tell you about Violent Night that I went to see last night. The new, like, comedy, it's marketed, I think, as a comedy horror. It's not, it's a comedy action. I was expecting horror. It has been compared to a cross between, what happened?
Someone's been into the back of that. Sorry, that white car's been pulling into the petrol station probably the last half an hour, and someone's wiped it out, taken back a car off.
Yeah, it was probably slowed down to 2 mile an hour, yeah. Turning the corner.
It's still got the hazards for it.
It's been compared to, like, a mix of Die Hard and Home Alone, which I get. There's a similar style. There's even, like, little rip-off moments, but it's not as good as either of those movies. I liked it, I enjoyed it, it was good, but it wasn't great, it wasn't fabulous, and it most certainly wouldn't be on my top movies of the year, which I've heard people say. I've heard people say it's their new favourite Christmas movie. David Harbour's really good in it. If you didn't know, guy that plays the sheriff in Stranger Things, Hopper, that's it. He's Santa, and he's excellent in it, and there needed to be more of him and less of the family. I think there was too much time given to the family. It needed to be more slapstick. It needed to be, people have said it's super violent. Yeah, there's a lot of blood, but it's very cartoony, it's very comic booky. It's not the sort, I would let Isaac watch that movie. It's that kind of movie. It's got quite a bit of bad language in, though, I will say, quite a bit of severe bad language in. but it was good, but it wasn't fantastic. So I just, a couple of tweaks could have made it a lot better. I loved the idea of the cantankerous Santa that was just fed up. That was good. But yeah, so I would recommend it, but I wouldn't say rush out and spend a lot of money seeing it in the cinema. If you can stream it, I don't know if they'll put it on streaming platforms before Christmas. They should. So yeah, that's what's happening. We put the Christmas decorations up yesterday, which you will have seen just a little shot of. I did try and film a couple of little houses last night that had Christmas decorations up, but you can't pick them up on video like they look when you drive past. It just doesn't work. But I don't think, is there anything remotely interesting to say about this week?
It's cold.
It's cold. It is cold. So that's Vlogmas, I suppose. It's cold. Thank you for watching this week, one of Vlogmas. I know there hasn't been much Christmassy other than the Christmas decorations and me posting my cards, but cough's still there. It's not gone yet. I shall catch up with you guys. Next week's going to be a stressful one, though. Gradings and exams. So I doubt there'll be much really Vlogmas-y next week that I can think of, Christmassy. I want to hopefully next Saturday go up to Belfast to watch a movie and have a buffet as a Chinese celebration for my birthday. You know the way Chinese have New Year later? Well, I'm having my birthday celebration later.
Thursday morning when he's at school.
So yeah, we'll probably go Saturday. That's sort of like a tradition I've done for the last few years. We go and get outside of COVID, we haven't done it when COVID was on, get a Chinese and watch a movie. So we'll do that. Thank you for watching, and I shall catch up with you guys next week.